Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. Let's continue our discussion on metabolic assays. As a lead advances through a drug discovery program, the team will eventually want to gather information on which CYP isoform is responsible for metabolizing the lead, as well as determining whether a lead inhibits any CYP isoforms. These types of studies often require multiple assays and are performed using automated screening techniques. To simplify the discussion, let's focus on three of the most important CYP isoforms in drug metabolism: CYP3A4, 2C9, and 2D6. And let's rely on the microsomal stability assays we mentioned in a different video. Let's first look at which isoform is responsible for lead metabolism. Let's say our liver microsomes contain three CYP isoforms, 3A4, 2C9, and 2D6. We could perform three assays with our lead, the microsomes, and a combination of known inhibitors. These are the colored X's. Assume CYP3A4 is the active isoform. In these examples, only assay 3 would show a decrease in lead concentration, because only 3A, or assay 3, has uninhibited 3A4. So we would see metabolite forming in assay 3. There are many ways to set up these experiments. The point of this slide is to show that these experiments are feasible. How do you identify if a lead is a CYP inhibitor? In theory, you could take a liver microsome assay with three different CYP isoforms and known substrates for each isoform. If addition of a lead slows the rate of conversion of one of the substrates, then you know that the lead is acting as an inhibitor on the corresponding CYP isoform. Again, this is just a proof of concept diagram. Why go through all this work on metabolism and inhibition? On the screen are two ideas. Idea number one: not all CYP isoforms are equally expressed in all patients. If your lead is metabolized by an inconsistently expressed isoform, then your lead will likely show variable clearance and therefore variable half-life. This fact may require variable dosing based on patient metabolism. Idea number two: if the lead inhibits some CYP isoforms, the lead may inhibit the metabolism of other drugs that a patient may be taking. In other words, by taking your lead as a drug, the clearance and half-life of other drugs may change. That is called a drug interaction, or drug-drug interaction, or DDI. It is a possible safety risk that needs to be identified early in a program. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please subscribe, like, or leave a comment or question. Take care.